I'm Dee Nolan, and this is our farm, Gum Park, which is at a little place called Hynum near Narracourt in the limestone coast of South Australia. We have 100 acres of organic farming, which is olive groves and sheep. And so the whole point of organic farming, we're certified organic, is that we don't use artificial chemicals, artificial fertilizers. And so really we're starting from the soil up. We're making sure that our soil is vibrant and healthy. And that it's very important to me that we have an integrated farming system. And so we're here in the olive grove. So our organic olive oil comes from these trees, but we also use the groves as grazing for our small South Down sheep stud. A stud is a flock of sheep of one breed, which you are breeding to get the purity and the pedigree of that breed. And we are breeding mostly rams for other farmers to buy to mate with their first cross ewes. And so farmers who are breeding prime lambs to sell as meat use different sires, different breeds of rams, and the South Down is one of those breeds. In Australia, the sheep that are bred for wool tend to have longer wool. So they're the Merinos and the Border Leicesters. The South Down has short wool, which is another reason why they are such good meat-producing sheep, because the energy that goes into producing long wool usually means with those breeds of sheep that do have long wool that they have a leaner frame, whereas the South Down with its shorter wool has a fuller frame and the big hindquarters that people want.
It's a very healthy meat. It's a little bit like Wagyu to a degree now, but not as fat. Different textured meat, different flavour. If it was on a taste test, the South Downs would be probably at the top, very similar to your Angus classified beef in that range. And on the other side of it, they're easy to work with, they're easy lambing. Breeding technique for artificial insemination basically is trying to mate the best with the best so we can produce the optimum rams to sell. They're basically going in through the side of the tummy and they're going into to the egg, where the eggs will be and releasing the semen around those eggs. Because they're using a microscope, internal long microscope, and that's pretty well to be able to put it right where it needs to be. It's a really calm and easy way to go about it. It's different to cattle, but it's been done for probably the last 35 years, and it's got very good and it's very consistent, with about 70% conception.
I'm actually standing on the edge of our birthing shed, and this is the paddock here, or two paddocks, where our ewes have their lambs. We've fox-proofed these two small paddocks so that we can be absolutely sure that our ewes can lamb down, you know, in safety from foxes, and the fences are also electrified. They've got two hot wires around them. This is a coat. This is called a woolover. And I'm sorry I don't have a newborn lamb to demonstrate it on, but these are real lifesavers when you get those graziers warnings. It's just an all-in-one little 100% wool. Their head goes through here, you just roll it up, and you put their head through there, and the little legs go through there, and their back legs go through there. And it's fantastic. It just gives them brilliant insulation if they're born on one of those nights. Good little fella, aren't you? Hey, we got you all healthy. There's your mum. Yeah. They were really almost an endangered breed 20 years ago. They've really kind of come back since then. But I think it's terribly important not to lose the gene pool in terms of our livestock. And there was a great practical reason, which is that they are more compact, they're shorter, and so they're great in the olive grove. We have a bit of a deal with them. Of course, they got to eat some of the trees. They love the olive leaves, and the olive leaves are full of antioxidants. They're allowed to sort of prune up to the bottom of the tree, so that saves me doing that pruning, and they get the health benefits of that.